With the Rocky Mountains in the background, the distance to the goal has shrunk to 3 kilometers. Let's take a look now at each of the racers. In the front of the crowd, we have Poco Loco from Georgia, followed by barefoot runner Sandman, from the Mongolian horse riding tribes Dot Han, Gaucho from Mexico, Baba Yaga from the Russian military, and with some space in between, Gyro Zappelli, then Johnny Joestar, who is currently ranking in 3rd, and England's Diego Brando. And now, it's Diego Brando who's acting bizarre. Dio is ranked 1st as of the end of the second stage with 150 points. Sandman is in 2nd with 140. If he can only beat Sandman, Diego Brando can take the lead. His biggest rival is Sandman, who's only 10 points behind. But for some reason, Dio is going after Gyro Zappelli, ranked in 6th place with 36 points. He's sicking right behind him. It seems that he's thinking that as long as he can beat Gyro Zappelli, he may have well won this stage. It seems that Dio is unconcerned with Sandman, who is far ahead. Dio, on that mountain, he's come to understand his stand ability. Is he going to start something here? Will he attack us here?
No, Gyro. There's no way Dio would risk being disqualified right here in front of the goal where the balloons are watching. He's planning on defeating you in this stage without breaking any rules. To him, moving past you is as good as moving past Sandman, which would lead him to victory. It's his fighting intuition. But be ready, Gyro. Dio is calculating. Even from this distance, the breath rate of our horses, their pulse rate, their perspiration, their stride length, that's what he's using his new dinosaur ability for. Dio is stealing our data more perfectly than ever.
Now, right before the goal, we have Lake Cannon with a circumference of 3,900 kilometers. Let me explain the lay of the land. If the racers choose to go right, they'll be taking the waterside route. It's flat, but there's a lengthy 2,400 meters until the finish line. Choosing left means a 700 meter shorter route of 1,700 meters, but that road's on a cliff and has many ups and downs. Which route will they choose? How will it affect the muscles of the horses that have been traveling through mountains for 5 days? This is a new experience for everybody, even the horses. Their choice will be their gamble.
We have to go right, Gyro, don't say left. Think of the horses. The key to victory will be how much rest we can give our horses.
As expected, Sandman has headed left. Oh, and Poco Loco follows. He's taking his chances with the cliff. The ones going right are Dot Han, followed by Baba Yaga and Gaucho, who have switched places. Johnny, you're right. We'll rest the horses, we'll go this way. Look at the map. The map of the lake. See the depth of the lake. It's only 2.2 meters at the deepest. Valkyrie can cross it. The length is only 450 meters. Super short.
Huh? What? You've got to be kidding!
What a surprise! A third route. Diego Brando follows Gyro Zappelli into the lake. But it may not be the wisest choices. The water resistance will wear out the horses like nothing else. And yet Dio, the genius jockey, has chosen that route. The distance is a much shorter 450 kilometers. It may just be the fastest route. This race has gotten a hell of a lot more interesting. A hell of a battle right in front of the goal.
Fuck. If you're scared, don't come. Is that it, Gyro? Damn it, Gyro. This is nuts, Gyro. It's like a horse carrying another horse while crossing. The water resistance requires muscles that aren't usually used. What if there's mud at the bottom? At that point, our horses will be finished.
That's why I'm slowing to a minimum. I won't put stress on their limbs. Just the speed I need to get ahead of the rest going around the lake. I'm sure that's what Dio's planning too. I'm going to get 100 points in this stage, no matter what. Or else, we'll be even further from victory. I came to this race to win. My fatherland is waiting.
Let's go back, Gyro. It's not too late. Let's go back to the shore and go around from the right. You can't defeat Dio. I don't want to say it, but this is my prediction. You won't get first place on the stage. This isn't about Dio calculating our horse's pulses or his dinosaur ability. It's not about your weak points. That's not what I'm talking about. It's, well, how do you say it? You should have been able to win the first and second stages based on technique and drive. you could have won.
What is it? Just say it. Hey, Johnny Joestar, if you're going to come up and talk to me like you're so great, then say it clearly.
I am being clear. You will lose to Dio. I can tell. You can't beat Sandman either. I can tell from experience. You may be thinking that the reasons you lost the first and second stages were because of trouble and accidents, but that's not it. There's a certain thing behind it all that caused your defeat. You've learned and inherited from your country and parents. You're running this race with technique and energy. I understand that you're cornered in a situation where you have to save an innocent boy sentenced to death. But those are all things that you've inherited. You are one who has continually inherited. Dio is different. He has stolen everything, from his horse skills to his social status, even food. Ever since his birth, Dio has been a person who has even stolen destiny. Dio is somebody who's hungered. You're a successor. I'm not saying which one is good or bad. The difference will show in the desperate moments of this race. The difference will steal your victory and eat you up.
Johnny, so is this what you're trying to say? That I'm spoiled by my parents and a coward? Is that it?
You can't win unless you hunger. But not like Dio. You need to hunger in a much more noble manner. I'm going back to shore. Sorry, but I'm taking the route to the right.
What did you say? What's this now? Dio has split up. Is it to agitate Gyro, or is it because everything has been already planned out? It looks like he wants to reach the shore and take the head position already one third of the way. He's slowly but surely distancing himself from Gyro.
Gyro, you can't win unless you hunger for it. But slowly. You can grow slowly. If you can grow slowly, then it will be someone like you, one of inheritance, who will win this race. You can be second or third on this stage. The race is still long. That's what I want to see. What I want to learn from you. That's why I wanted to follow you on the Steel Ball Run race. But...
And amazing! Gyro's going for it. He's going to accept Dio's challenge. He's speeding up. Ugh, Johnny. That fucker. Shit. Because of all that weird stuff he said, Valkyrie can sense that I'm agitated. Damn it, he's throwing me off. Johnny doesn't understand your potential. He thinks we're just some idiots crossing a lake. But Valkyrie, you've got a special skill waiting for when we get to the land on the other side. That's why we need to be careful not to get distracted by Dio's movements while we're in the water. Gyro's horse's pulse. Currently 198. After breathing twice, it'll take a deep breath and shift its body to the left. Then it'll shake its neck. Neither Gyro nor his horse know this, but his horse will step onto land with its left foot, and anticipating the length of the horse's stride, he will step on that branch with its 75th step. About 300 meters from the goal, if it indeed steps on that branch, then that's where the horse reaches its top speed. Its pulse rate will be 263. At that moment, the horse will be overcome with fatigue. So, although I'm taking a risk by crossing this lake so quickly, if I can stay ahead of Gyro at the point of that branch, there's no way he can catch up to my horse. Until then, all I have to do is stay ahead. Just until that branch, stay ahead. Dot Han, Gaucho, and Baba Yaga are speeding up. They are coming around from the right-hand side. Sandman has cleared the cliffs and is also heading straight towards the goal. It looks like Dio's finally back on land. Dio is in the lead. It's Dio, 500 meters remaining. Not yet, Valkyrie. Don't get excited yet. Save your energy till the very end. Pocoloco has also cleared the cliffs. Don't run yet. This lake is a vacation resort. Think of it like a Caribbean beach. Johnny Joestar is closing in on Dot Han. Not yet, a little more. Rest a little more. And now, Gyro Zappelli finally back on land. Left foot. And he begins to accelerate. Gyro Zappelli. He's now running at a tremendous speed. It's almost as if he's a hunting dog going after a rabbit. He's right on Dio's trail. Good lord! Gyro Zappelli is beginning to throw his luggage off of his horse. He must be trying to lighten his horse's burden. His blanket soaked with water, his wet leather bag, his canteen, everything. He's steadily increasing speed as he discards his things. He's even getting rid of his saddle. The only things he's keeping are his reins. Everything else is being tossed aside. He's thrown off his jacket and cape, even his trademark holster. 3 more steps. 2. 1 step. Alright. He's reached his stop speed by now, and I'm still ahead. But he can't shorten his distance. Gyro is a pelly. He can't catch up. He can't take the lead. Valkyrie cannot go any faster. And now he's slowing down with 200 meters left. Both are feeling the strain from crossing the lake. But Dio is managing to stay ahead. Falling behind, looks like fatigue is finally taking a toll on Gyro. Suddenly, the gap is widening. Pocoloco has just passed Gyro. He's running. Dio continues to stay ahead. Gyro Zappelli is falling behind. Dot Han is coming up behind him, only half a horse's length away. How's this weight, Valkyrie? Is it a little lighter? They say that 70% of the human body is water. Show some guts, Valkyrie. We were called spoiled cowards. Is that right? You're not a coward, are you? These steel balls I've inherited from my homeland. These steel balls are on our side. Gyro Zappelli is sweating buckets. His sweat is running off him like the Colorado River. Here he comes. Here he comes. Here he comes. Here he comes. With 80 meters left, Gyro, who had fallen behind, is accelerating once more. He finally takes the lead from Dio. Impossible. That should have been his top speed. That was his limit. Yet he accelerated? Ugh. Gastroliths. Valkyrie is wobbling. She's losing her balance. Gyro Zappelli tumbles. 30 meters remaining. 10 meters. Goal! Johnny Joestar. Johnny Joestar. What a turn of events. The order is Johnny Joestar, then Diego Brando, then Gyro Zappelli. Followed by Poco Loco running in, Sandman, Don Juan, Baba Yaga, Mac the Knife, and Gaucho, who fell behind. There was an incident right before the goal where Diego Brando stepped on a small rock, which happened to hit Gyro's horse, and during the time the two racers lost their balance due to this incident, Johnny Joestar came to the lead. It was only by chance that Dio happened to step on this rock. There was no proof that it was intentional. Therefore, Diego Brando will not be disqualified. The reason for my defeat wasn't because of an accident, but something that looms behind me. You said... Maybe you're right, Johnny. Maybe just as you said, I need to hunger more than Dio. And even more than you, Johnny. You're trying to find that corpse of the saint during the race, and that's what you want more than anything. You're hungering for it, and you want it no matter what. Maybe I should try to follow your example. Maybe seriously searching for those corpses will help me grow a little. At this point, the fourth stage has already begun. Johnny Joestar is the one who conquered the dead heat battle just now, but an hour ago, Hot Pants had already passed through the finish line to take first place. Therefore, the placements for the third stage are as listed on the chart to the right. Hot Pants receives 100 points and a 1 hour time bonus. What the? Already past the finish line? Hot Pants!